Hi everybody, in this video we're going to cover one of the most fundamental operations used in computer vision, which is 2D convolution. Hi there and welcome to LearnOpenCV. The convolution operation starts with the concept of a filter, which is also referred to as a kernel, usually 3x3 or sometimes 5x5, which is used to process an input image and transform that image to something that might be more useful for downstream processing. In this example, we show how a 6x6 input is convolved with a 3x3 kernel. Here we use a well-known kernel often used in image processing called a Sobel kernel, which is designed to detect vertical edges. The convolution operation consists of placing the filter over a portion of the input and multiplying the elements of the filter with the corresponding elements of the input. The resulting value is a single number representing the output of the convolution operation for a given filter location. Sliding the filter one pixel at a time corresponds to a stride of 1. The filter location is shown in dark blue, and this region is also referred to as the receptive field. Notice that the center of the filter is indicated in green. The convolution operation performed at each filter location is simply the dot product of the filter values with the corresponding values in the receptive field in the input data. A sample calculation is provided for the first two filter locations so you can confirm your understanding of the operation. Notice that at each filter location, the operation produces a single number placed at the corresponding location in the output. In other words, the location in the output corresponds to the center of the receptive field overlaid on the input slice. Notice that the output from the convolution operation has a smaller spatial size than the input slice. This has to do with how the filter is placed over the input data so that it does not extend beyond the boundary of the input. However, padding techniques are often used to pad the input image so that the output is the same size as the input. Using a stride larger than 1 will also reduce the size of the output from the convolution operation. Before we continue, we wanted to give you a more concrete example of how specific kernels can detect basic structures in an image. This is a really nice website that allows you to interactively experiment with various kernels using a pixelated input image so that you can appreciate the computations involved in the convolution operation and the associated output shown to the right. As you can see, when the kernel moves from left to right across the image, it's able to detect vertical edges in the input image. Other kernels can also be used to detect different types of edges, for example, horizontal edges or diagonal edges. So that's an example of how 2D convolution is used in image processing. But this concept has been extended and generalized for use in neural networks, and specifically convolutional neural networks, in which there are special layers within those networks that perform the convolution operation on not just the input images, but intermediate data throughout the network. In a convolutional neural network, there's one important distinction, and that is that the values of the kernel are learned by the network during the training process. So rather than trying to engineer what kernel to use for a specific problem, a CNN will automatically learn those values during the training process. But regardless of this distinction, the convolution operation itself is the same. So let's have a look at this in more detail. In this example here, we're showing how a single filter is used to process a grayscale image as the input to a convolutional neural network. And notice that the weights in the filter, which are the elements of the kernel, are not fixed, but are shown as variable, meaning that those values are learned during the training process. And therefore, CNNs have the ability to detect many different types of features automatically. In other words, the network is incentivized to come up with kernels that extract meaningful features, whatever those may be. So if you're interested in learning more about convolutional neural networks, we have an introductory video on that topic that we've provided a link to here, which is part of our TensorFlow and Keras Getting Started series. So you might want to take a look at that to get a more comprehensive understanding of how the convolution operation is used within neural networks. So that's all we wanted to cover in this video on the convolution operation. If you found this video helpful, please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel to get more content on computer vision, deep learning and AI.